Show the world. Let them know it's Halloween. Hit it!
Hello everyone, Jason Alia back here again, and today I want to be able to talk about this new article that just came out from Variety regarding Jurassic World and the entire franchise as a whole. Now the article is written by Zach Scharf, I'm sorry if I mispronounced your name, and it is titled Jurassic World Director Says Series Should Have Probably Ended After Spielberg's Original? It's inherently unfranchisable. Bruh. I know if you haven't seen the amount of money these movies make, but not one has been a box office bomb. Not one. But let's continue. Let's see what the director has to say. Jurassic World Dominion recently crossed the $1 billion mark. Yada, yada, yada. Colin Trevorrow suggests to Empire Magazine that none of the sequels should have ever been made? Not even his own movies? Okay, that's an interesting take. Yeah, I don't know how to feel about this. Because he directed one of these sequels. Two of these sequels, in fact. So let's see what he got to say. In Trevorrow's own words, the Jurassic franchise probably should have started and ended with Spielberg's original. I specifically did something different than the other films in order to change the DNA of the franchise. Trevorrow said that about Jurassic World Dominion. The previous five films are plots about dinosaurs. This one is a story about characters in a world in which they coexist with dinosaurs. Okay, I see where he's going with this because, quite frankly, Jurassic World Dominion, from what I've seen, does not really have dinosaurs folk as like the plot of its own story. It's mostly a world inhabited by dinosaurs, and it's just there. They're just there for the action sequences, and they have a little bit of purpose here and there, like the T-Rex subplot of going up against the Giganosaurus, but that's like in the extended edition more so than in the theatrical cut. But I could see where he's going with this, he talked about Dominion in comparison to the other film. And I could kind of see Fallen Kingdom as more so the end of the Jurassic franchise, as in now in full circle to dinosaurs in the mainland. I don't know. Let's continue. Trevorrow then called the franchise inherently unfranchisable, said that there probably should have been one Jurassic Park, but if we're going to do it, how can I allow them to tell stories in a world in which dinosaurs exist as opposed to here's another reason why we're going to an island? Even though he doubted the durability of the overall franchise, Trevorrow told Empire that he made Dominion so that the Jurassic movies could continue if need to be. So I guess there goes that whole concept of this being the conclusion of the Jurassic era, like the marketing suggests. Trevorrow directed the original Jurassic World movie, sat out the sequel, Fallen Kingdom, then returned for Dominion. This movie clearly takes a real interest in creating new characters that a new generation is going to latch on to. Kilowatt, Mamoudou at the... I'm sorry, I'm bad with names. If you're watching this, which is probably not likely, I'm sorry. Character Ramsey Cole, who I think in the extended edition, you really feel his purpose in a greater way, the director said. And Deshaun Latchman's character, Soyona Santos, who just gets arrested at the end. There's more to come. So it seems like from this article that he never intended Dominion to be the end of the franchise. He created it as a way for more stories to be told within a world filled with dinosaurs. So let's say it's more so like it's going to be a cinematic universe, like the Marvel cinematic universe. And in my opinion, that seemed like a good way to make this franchise franchisable, like give more variety and more storytelling opportunities for directors and filmmakers, and have different ideas pop out. And so, yeah, I don't really see Dominion now as like the conclusion anymore. I see it as the conclusion to the characters and their arcs that we've seen from Jurassic World and Jurassic Park. Like, most likely we're not going to see at least most of those characters ever again. Certainly not likely Alan or Ellie Sattler now that they moved on. I do hope they keep Ian Malcolm, as he's like the most important character to these films. And honestly, I think I understand where he's coming from, because so far the first movie, how that wrapped up, is perfect. Like, it did not need any sequels, but it made a lot of money. So inherently, the studio wants more money. So in that concept, it was going to be franchisable whether the filmmakers liked it or not. But I understand his point where he's coming from. I think from now seeing Dominion from this point of view, I could say that they did the best of what they could. I mean, as someone who really enjoys, in particular, the extended edition of the film, I could understand how this is not really the end, as it really doesn't feel like the finale of the franchise when I watched it. At least even the extended edition, I never got the sense that this is like a finale of the franchise. I got a sense that this is the conclusion of these characters that we're probably gonna see for the last time ever. So yeah, I am very interested in the future Jurassic Park. From what I think, there's gonna be a bit more movies and probably an announcement of what movies there is to come next year, but I do hope we get like TV shows and something a bit more grounded. Trevorrow's trilogy has been a bit more Indiana Jones like in an adventure sense. Like, these felt like more like adventure movies, and I enjoyed the world films for in that aspect, honestly. Like, I enjoy so far every Jurassic Park movie, despite their issues I have with each and every one of them. But I want something now that feels a little bit more grounded, a little bit different from the world movies and the park movies. I want variety. I want filmmakers to be able to tell their stories in this world the way they want to tell it. And I feel like what Colin Trevorrow did with Dominion, it gives opportunity for that. Because if this franchise is going to keep making more money, you might not want to have to market your films as like the conclusion. I think that was kind of a bad idea and basically mismarketed the film. But overall, I am excited for more shows or movies to come. If it's Jurassic Park, I welcome it with open arms, whether it's good or bad. I'm a purist, but don't worry, I'm not going to shy away from problems. As you know, I did not shy away from the problems of Fallen Kingdom or Jurassic Park 3 or even World or Dominion, because I even have problems with those movies despite me enjoying them quite a bit. But Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. Are you excited for more movies and shows to come or not? And I'll see you guys next time.